Hello Harpers, I'm Tiffany Schaefer and this is Tune Tutor, where we learn traditional tunes by ear. I teach tunes like this every month, so if you're new here, be sure and subscribe so you can catch the next one. Today I'm excited that we're starting Christmas music, and by popular vote the first one up is Carol of the Bells. I'm going to play it for you first, the whole thing, my arrangement, which you can purchase down in the description box. There's a link to my store. And then we're going to go through some tips for playing the melody. And if you want a full arrangement tutorial of this, you can learn it by ear and learn exactly where all the lever flips go, etc. My patrons get those over on patreon.com/tiffanyharpist. There's going to be one of this full arrangement, and there's also going to be one for beginner patrons who will take the actual sheet music and just simplify it a bit and make it work for absolute beginners. This sheet music right now, I would say, is sort of an early intermediate level. And if you are a patron, you'll know you can also sign up to get sheet music once a month that correspond with these tune tutorials. So if you don't want to purchase the sheet music, if you're already a patron, you can check it out and see if that level is right for you, and you'll get a new piece of sheet music delivered to Patreon every month. Let's dive right in. This is an A minor. There's no levers at all if you're tuned in C. So everything on your harp should be natural. And it starts on a C. So as you know, the first phrase is just a repeated. I do that four times before I bring in any left hand. And the fingering I like to use is 1, 2, 1, 3. I don't place 3 in the beginning. I place it right as I'm playing that C for a second time. And there are some fingering suggestions in the sheet music, just so you know. So after we've done that 4 times, ad nauseum, then I start bringing in my harmonics here. Just go all the way down, come back up to F. Now, You don't have to do harmonics, certainly, if they're not your strong suit. You could just... play down like that. And since this little motif is repeated so often throughout the whole song, it's, I think it's really important to give it a little bit of personality. And don't play it the same way all the time through. Try and give it a little bit of lift. I like to sort of emphasize the very first note. That's exaggerated a bit, but you can kind of get the idea of what I mean. Those other notes are kind of an afterthought. And then of course you can get softer and louder as the piece goes on. So after we've done that several times, that's the opening four times, and then you have your walk down. And then we let it go by itself. This is where I bring in my tenths and the rest of my left hand. We do that again, and then we come up here, same fingering. And this is where, of course, the left hand comes in with... That part is where I really like to grow it and get start soft. Grow louder, and then bring it back down. And then play it again. So that you can really think of these little motifs in groups of four. And then one, two, three, four. Same thing here. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. So the next part of the melody that's going to start on this high A, and then I grab a C and an E. To fill out the chord I'm doing in my left hand. So let's just try that. It's A with a chord underneath, and then you hit another A and just climb down to E, and you have two E's. Then we have our next little grouping. I don't do any chords, they are in the right hand. That section starts on a D, down to C, two more Ds, up to E again, and we're back to that same motif. Okay, so I'm going to play that together. So for fingering, you can do either 3-2-1 here, or 4-2-1, whatever is more comfortable. And then I do 2-3-4. You could bring your thumb back down for that second E. And then you're ready to go on down. 2-3-2-2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Just like that. And then we have this part, you've already flipped the levers at this point. The F and the G. And then this part I like to use fingers 3-2-1, 3-2-1. So we're starting on E here, the E right above middle C, and I've got 3-2-1 placed. This you're gonna have to cross under. So before you play your thumb on G, just bring your third finger and get it ready on A, and then you can bring 2 and 1 up there on B and C. So just practice that. Once you've got that, continue on up. You can cross under this time. Before you play the C with your thumb, cross under two onto D. And then your thumb is ready on E. Back down we go. We play that run twice. And then we're back, we flip those levers down. I have a harp where I can easily flip two levers next to each other at the same time. So that's kind of handy. Or if you can't do that, just do them one right after the other. And we're back to this. Basically after this, I play a little bit of left hand, which is... big A minor chord there. And then we're back to the beginning. And we just repeat that whole entire thing. Now in my arrangement, when we get to the second ending, we're doing this part. A few times. So we've done the run up twice. And then we do this run and stop it short. So we do that a few more times. And I just have an E on the bottom there. So for the second ending, we're doing that. Remember, our levers are up. Actually, both Fs and Gs. So I do that four times, that run there. And here's a little ornament you can throw in at the very end there. That's a little cut from the E to the D. You put an extra E on there. That's just a really extra, a tiny, tiny, short, extra E that goes right before the D. Like you pinch them together. And then we're ready for the ending. We're back to the motif here. And this is where I start slowing it way down. Then we have the melody up high, just that same motif. And then we have the end. So that's pretty much running through the whole of the melody, and I hope you enjoy the sheet music. Thanks for having a look at this with me. We've got two more, possibly three more Christmas tutorials coming up. Put in the comments, what is your favorite Christmas carol to play? Maybe you'll give me some ideas for next year. And if you want to see some more Christmas tutorials, click right over there. If you want to see some more regular tutorials, you can click the one above that. If you want to subscribe, click my face. And if you want those extra goodies like monthly sheet music and extra tutorials, click the Patreon logo up there. I'll see you next time. Bye!